When it comes to emergency exit signage, there is one burning question that people really struggle to answer clearly, and that is, should the arrow go up or down when the sign is positioned above a doorway? Now, we have looked hard to try and find this answer in the places you might expect to find it. The IET Guide to Emergency Lighting for Electricians, the NICE EIC Snags and Solutions Book for Emergency Lighting, but we couldn't find a concrete answer. So that meant we had to send Gary around town to some of his favorite haunts to see if that would unveil the answer when it comes to emergency exit signage. Now, we think we've found the answer, so stick around to find what it is. And what did you think?
So I've ascertained from that there's a high chance us electricians are going to get it wrong, and I can't think of anything worse than maybe sticking something onto an emergency light and trying to peel it back off when you've actually got them pointing in the wrong direction. However, this Adler range from Ansell has got us covered.
Yeah, but you immediately defaulted to the cheapest possible exit sign you could think of with a self-adhesive graphic. This range from Ansell looks absolutely gorgeous. Do we say that about emergency signs? Well, I think we can in this range. It comes in two variants. We've got the slim exit box type sign here, and we've got a double-sided blade sign that we'll come back to later as well. But it's that flexibility in terms of the arrows. From one product, you can be covered for most of the signage needs on a project because you can change them instantaneously on site by putting either interchangeable running person, which can be on the left or the right, and the arrow can be up, down, left or right as well, which again covers most requirements on a project.
There's some other great features you want to highlight as well, isn't there?
There is. So obviously step in, it's all about battery life. So this battery is warranted for 5 years, which matches the warranty you get on the sign. Obviously being LED, it is low energy. And with this, you get 36,000 hours of lamp life to L70. Great to see that quoted in the data sheet as well. You'll notice another great feature there is the exit box version itself. Slightly higher power consumption than the exit sign because of this additional LED here that provides some of that illumination you'd need for the escape route. That in some installations, you would have in the past had to fit an additional unit alongside the exit sign.
When I think about emergency light fins, I think about getting my large bunch of keys and obviously the key that operates the key switch in order to check them regularly.
I call them fish keys, Gary, myself. What's the audience call them? And you've built up an extensive range there, Gary, over the years, just in case you're in somewhere and think, I'm going to do a 3-hour duration test.
And have you got that problem solved?
It is solved in this, because these signs are all self-testing, so that'll do the monthly functional test and also a 3-hour duration test once a year, which is obviously a requirement under emergency lighting legislation. But how many people actually do that? Have you seen an updated logbook everywhere you go?
No, but they're still going to have to go around and perhaps check the status LED, aren't they, after that's happened periodically?
Yeah, so it's not a central test, so it doesn't report back to a central and email people off. Obviously, watch for that status indication and also that the sign is illuminated when it should be. But that pretty much covers most of your emergency lighting tests and needs. And the other thing is good. You'll notice this one's black.
I do, yeah, I noticed that one. I did notice that one's black.
So think of that trend we see now in the modern building. Now people take away the suspended ceiling and paint all the services black. So you can have your exit sign in both versions in black or white, depending on the decor, which I think another great little flexibility function from Ansell.
This exit sign here looks as if it's got 5 members of the family, but they only sent one box through to us, didn't they?
Well, it is, because it's a 5-in-1. This is literally like a Swiss Army knife. You can mount it direct to the ceiling. You can mount it semi-flush into the ceiling. You can mount it on the wall, and you can actually suspend it from the wires as well. So think of all those different options you could have in a building. You don't necessarily know it when you're quoting or when you're at that ordering stage which version you need. They're pretty much all covered there, including also a side mount version as well.
Well, we seem to be circling around the answer. Does the arrow go up above an exit door or below an exit door? And I've had divine interventions I went round the town because I think the church may have got it right.
Well, in God we trust, Gary. The rest of it we turn to the ICEL committee because they're bound to have it right. But before I got there, actually, there was a lot of confusion, even amongst us, depending on what document you read, about that arrow. So I asked the audience because I was unsure.
Oh, yeah,
couldn't phone a friend. Nearly 2,000 votes, and the eFIXX audience, 63% think the arrow goes down.
Okay.
and 37% think it goes up.
And as we've asked the audience on YouTube, that must be exactly the correct answer, that arrow goes down. But it's not quite as simple as that, depending on which of the standards we're following, is it?
Yeah, so the latest recommendation from ICEL is that you should follow the standard given in ISO 7010.
Okay, I remember reading it.
It's incorporated in BS 5266, which I'm sure you have read cover to cover. And the recommendation in there is that the arrow goes up.
Ah, so I come to an exit door, the arrow points up because I'm going
forward
through the door. So that makes up correct then, is that true?
Up is correct for most instances.
Okay, unless, most instances, yeah, elaborate.
Unless you were going to a door and then you were going to go downwards, so downstairs, it would point in the down direction.
So that suggests to me that the church that I went to got the signage wrong because the arrow was pointing down, and so were some other places in Skipton I went to, but they're not incorrect, are they?
Well, a bit like the eFIXX audience, kind of stuck in the past, because there was a previous version of the EU signage directive, which was the term when we started getting rid of the word exit from a lot of signage, and we went to the pictograms. Under that previous guidance, there was a slightly different colour of green, and the arrow wasn't defined whether it went up or down in those instances.
And now you mentioned that green is subtly different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so in that case, then maybe when I was in Greg's the Baker's and the arrow was pointing downwards under that directive, it was probably right that I was exiting through that. Oh, that's a little bit, not confusing, but it takes a little bit of thinking. Now, if you go back to the pictures that we had earlier on in the presentation, you're going to see some correct and then some more correct, but under two different directives now, but there is still some that are incorrect. If you've spotted them, make sure you leave a comment below.
The great news is, with this range from Ansell, you can relax a little bit because they are covering it for most instances in terms of direction. Obviously, colour, illumination, all the other things that you have to worry about. Just be careful if you're in a building where there's a mixture of signage between old and new, and you may have to get some guidance off the local fire authority to get the right answer.
The keynote amongst you will have noticed this on the table, my MFT tester and this plug-in light meter. And in this video, I'll show you how to use it in order to measure lux levels.